Hello to you all. Here we are. Alright, this is good. This is not a re-record episode. We're looking forward to the futuristic horizon with the element of surprise, such as this lady right here. Who knows what her name is? Probably a flower-related pun. Selena. I'm not a flowery person, so that could be a flower-related pun. I don't know. If you do have the answer, write it down and send it to Post Office Box 6295 and mark your envelope with "I know more about flowers than Dark Justice 42. Give me some prize or something." So, yes, we've got a new person. What's his favorite kind of Pokemon? I wonder what it is. He's a small man. Sandshrew. Okay, yeah, that's cool. I like Sandshrew. Sandshrew has like a bricky pattern on his everywhere except his chest. I don't know. So he's got Sentry. He does not anymore have Sentry. Umbriel is going great. She's got Faint Attack. I should use it then, but I didn't. Why bother? Let's go. We're gonna beat the guys. No, we'll just steal some things. Oh damn, that's right. We need to use Rock Smash. Alright. Let's go back to the Pokemon Center and get out our faithful Unicorn Man. I bet Unicorn Man is excited. He finally gets to see some rock smashing action. Should have just gone off draw. Too bad. Remember in Gold and Silver when that took forever? Yeah, the third generation was the hugest leap between generations in all of Pokemon, in my opinion. Hello. Well, guess what? Well, you have failed, fat man. I will... DOLL! Okay. Yep. Let's go get Rock Smash. I figured that I didn't. Just running back and forth. Okay. Here's a cool house. It's grey. Yo, give me the thing. Alright. We've got the Rock Smash. I know. Yes, I didn't care. Now, bag, rock smash. I'm sure he does. Yes, it shall. Bye. Okay, Unicorn Man has got a rock smash and cut. Now, we could go and fix the tunnel, and that would help out those two guys a lot. I'm sure they'd really enjoy it. But no, they can just dig their own tunnel. We're going upward bound. Take that. Let's see if we can find some new exciting Pokemon. That'd be nice. Oh, okay, forget that. We're going to go... We don't need your exciting Pokemon. We don't need your double battle, though. What's up? Where am I going? I am going, at the moment, to... Lava Ridge, after a detour in Volcano Land to beat the teams, because they're just jerks, you know. So we're going to there. There is a good place to be. There we beat Morville in that. Wait, what? No, we beat Watson in the last episode, and we're beating Marill now, because Picnic or Irene isn't even as strong as Watson. No, I thought I could do it. Okay, Faint Attack instead. Yeah, new moves. Forget the fact that Gummy had it 16 levels ago. We've got it now. So take that, Gummy. Also, the number 127 is showing its face again. It keeps doing that. I swear it's everywhere. There's a conspiracy here, people. Haha, Peppy. Do a bowel roll. Another camper with a Sandshrew. Wow, look at Sanshu's eyes. Whoa. Oh, thanks for that, Umbriel. I was getting rather hypnotized. So, we are going. There's numbles here, but there's not any more. We're going to go into the grass. Let's find something exciting. Let's find something shiny and exciting. Ooh, okay. Duskull's pretty cool. We're not going to catch him. We're not going to catch anything. Unless, of course, we find something legendary or shiny. And even then, I doubt we'll be catching it, because we've only got Pokeballs. And one does not simply catch legendaries with Pokeballs. I'm not singing with you. Go away. I don't sing. I'm not a singing person. Or an acting person. I don't do much. We faint attack that Taillow. Or if it was backwards, Wallyat. It's a silly name. Why would you own a Pokemon called Wallyat? This trainer clearly knows nothing. Mol? Okay. That's not as bad as Mollyat. Wow. Lumbre backwards is Herb Mol, as in herb, but Jamaican. So, he's a hiker. He's a hiker. Let's run past the hiker. We couldn't run past the hiker. Well, it's a good thing your legs are solid. If they were liquid, that'd be a problem. That'd be a serious problem. It'd be worse if they were gas. It would literally have been vaporized. That wouldn't be fun. I know I wouldn't like to be vaporized. Faint attack. That's good. That's good. I can, yeah, see? Remember when Judo's used to be a problem? Neither do I. That whole Rustboro gym battle never happened. I won it instantly for a single hit, and if anyone claims otherwise, they're just an idiot. Same goes with the Doofa gym battle and the Morville gym battle. In fact, I don't even recall any gyms. There were no gyms. We're writing a new chapter in the pages of history now. Everything behind us is just the past. It's not important how many times it took to beat any of the gym leaders. That's especially, no, that's not even slightly important. What matters is, it's done. We've got the badges. I don't think that anyone back there mattered at all. Maybe Professor Beardy, and maybe Giddy the hipster. That's it. Really? You know, the preferred watching order? This entire thing? Watch episode 1. Watch episode 2. Yeah, maybe go to 3. Oh, Blossom! Then go straight to here, episode 24. That's right. That's what happened. There's nothing in the middle. You can just speed that up and put some catchy J-pop music over it. Blossom is cool. I would like to catch one. I probably shouldn't, but screw the rules. I have money. We're going to catch this Blossom if we can. No, we can't. Alright, forget that, Blossom. I'm sure there's a better one. We're level 37, that's what really matters. Cypher's Pokedex number is 123. Pinsir's is 127. They should have been closer together because they used to be rival Pokemons, but now they're not because it's just apparently Heracross and Pinsir are rival Pokemons. That's not right. What have you done? Butterfree, eh? Butterfree. Take that, synchronized. Oh, look how easy it would be to catch. We're gonna catch a Butterfree, guys. Don't tell the shiny Metroid. Don't tell anyone facilitating this competition. I suppose it's usually me. But screw that. I've murdered me. And we've got a Butterfree. We need a name for this fellow. We're going to call him Slippers. Hooray for Slippers. He will do nothing. He's the guy. He's Unreal's friend. He blends in the background. Oh, look at that! Oh, I want to catch that. I'm going on a catching spree from catching deprivation. Looks like it's going to be difficult to catch. I don't really want anything that uses water sport anyway. And by Lardock, what were you thinking? This cave is filled with such amazing, beautiful Pokemon. Like, butterflies and hula dancers and... Yay! Well, awesome. I am so catching you. As if I could ever say no to that face. Quick attack. Right, that's good. That's good. That's not good. Well, that's harder. We'll try anyway. We're gonna catch this Blossom. And screw the rules. No, Blossom. I don't like you anymore. We don't need you. We've got Slippers. You tell them, Slippers. Slippers is better than you could ever be. I don't think Butterfree can learn any HMs. It'd be nice if it could learn Fly. But I'm pretty sure it can't. I'd say that for about a 90% certainty. Double battles, oh no, I've got Unicorn Mana Slippers. Okay, I'll take them on individually. Because that's always an option. Okay. Is she coming on to me? Shayla, is that a flower pun? I don't know, because all the other ones have been. You got Rose, Daisy, I have no idea about Selena. But no idea about her. Does anyone know anything about flowers? Are you a florist? Because I want to have you on the team. On Team Umbriel. That's what we should do. From now on, it's Team Umbriel and Team Gummy. You could also be on Team Unicorn Man. Your team is not likely to win. Oh, come on. Yeah, that's a good idea. Should be Team Gummy and Team Umbriel. I'll open up some t-shirts and desktop wallpapers and whatever. It'll be amazing. I'll use that as the bonus content for the end of this video, which should be coming up soon. I should have recorded the time and such where it started. I have no idea how long this is going to be. It could be really short. Could be 20 minutes. Time flies when you're playing Pokemon. Let's talk to this guy. He caught hot Pokemon. Is he coming on to me as well? Umbriel's a chick magnet. Now then. Burned. No. No. Numel has a silly cry. He was all like, wah, wah, wah. I'll turn the music up. So hopefully it can be heard by people listening and watching. You're watching. That's television terms. I don't like you, Slugma. Shiny Metroid was entirely right. I do not like Slugma. Not after what they did to me. And I got 300 experience. This is experience! Now then. Desert. Can't go there. He's cool. I like this guy. He's got a whale-mer. Not a whale-lord. I think it does come later on when you register him in your Pokemon decks. Not the Pokemon decks. Instead, the Pokemon navigation system. Winged attack for the win. Leer. Blah. Don't be intimidated by that Electric Umbriel. You're 20 levels higher than he'll ever be. Then this is a rematch. So, faint attack. Bam. Didn't see that one coming. Did you? Critical hit. Alright. Oh, come on. I'm so sick of paralysis. I should have used a paralyze heal. Do I have one? I don't think I have one anymore because I used it in gym. Yeah, I used to have one. Now I don't. So, quick attack. Come on! This sucks. Alright. See, I did that without having to pull a switcheroo. Thank you very much, the shiny Metroid. Now, we've got Whalmer. Wilton's Whalmer, as it were. Oh, rollout. Yes, I had to deal with Miltank as well. Those were dark days. Dark days amid the pages of history. Which is a metaphor I've used twice in this episode. And that's enough to make it the name of the episode, I think. Speaking of the name of the episode, it's been about 4 minutes since I last started recording. So let's look at this tree as we say goodbye to all of you. Goodbye. But I